Welcome to part 3 of the tutorial series, How to Play the Savage Soul. In this part, we'll examine every action and reaction available to combatants in a Savage Soul combat round. If you watch this entire video, you'll know everything a combatant can do. But if you're interested in just one or two actions or reactions, please feel free to consult the timestamps and go directly to those sections. While it may be hard to believe, the available actions and reactions listed in the Savage Soul cover everything a character might possibly do in combat. So, each time a character is designated to activate, he must choose one of the listed actions. Similarly, a character can only react to actions of another character by performing one of the listed reactions. While this may sound limiting, it is actually the opposite, and allows characters to benefit from tactical thinking based upon an awareness of exactly what their opponents can do in response. Every action and reaction has a token cost, which is either discard, free, or discard or free. If the token cost of an action or reaction is discard, a character may only perform the action or reaction if he is able to discard a ready token or a motivation token. Thus, if a character has no token left for the combat round, he cannot perform that action or reaction. If the token cost of an action or reaction is free, the character may perform the action or reaction without discarding a ready or motivation token, provided the required conditions for the action or reaction are met. Thus, a character may perform such an action or reaction even if he has no token remaining. If the token cost of a reaction is discard or free, a character performing the reaction must discard a ready or motivation token if he is able to do so, but may still perform the reaction even if he has no token to discard. The most common example of a discard or free reaction is active defense. By attacking an enemy that has not yet activated, the attacker may force his enemy to discard his token and be unable to strike back. But even if the enemy has already expended his token for the combat round, the enemy will still be able to defend himself. And so, the reaction is discard or free. Each action and reaction will also specify what type of move a character can perform in connection with the action or reaction, including any change in facing. Movement and facing are explained in detail in the next tutorial, but a character's movement entitlement will always be governed by the action or reaction he is performing. Additionally, if an action or reaction allows for movement, that movement must occur before any other element of the action or reaction. So, for example, when performing a charge and strike action, the character may perform a restricted move of up to twice his movement meters, and then attempt to make a melee weapon attack. The character cannot attempt an attack and then move, or move, attempt an attack, and then move again. Finally, each action or reaction will specify whether it causes strain or extreme strain. Basically, anything a character does in combat, other than resting, will cause strain, which means the character will have to make a willpower attempt to resist gaining the winded condition at the end of every 12 combat rounds, which is approximately equal to 1 minute of continuous fighting. If an action or reaction causes extreme strain, however, a character must roll to resist the winded condition each time he performs the action or reaction. For example, a sprint action allows a character to move up to 3 times his relevant move meters, but the character must attempt to resist the winded condition for each sprint he performs. In contrast, a double time action, which allows for a move of up to twice the character's relevant move meters, only causes strain, so a character could double time for 12 combat rounds before having to resist the winded condition. If a character does gain the winded condition, He will suffer penalties to certain attributes and cannot perform any action or reaction that causes extreme strain. Each action and reaction will now be briefly illustrated. In a strike action, a character that is already within melee range of an intended target discards a token to attempt a melee attack. Attacks, blocks, and dodges will be explained in the tutorial on resolving attacks. In a charge and strike action, a character discards a token to perform a restricted move of up to twice his relevant move meters, and then perform a free strike action against a target within melee range. In a shoot action, a character discards a token to attempt a ranged attack against a target that is within range of his chosen weapon, provided all other requirements are satisfied, such as line of sight. In a move and shoot action, a character discards a token to perform an unrestricted move of up to his relevant move meters, and then performs a free shoot action with a -2 attack penalty. In a double time action, a character discards a token to perform an unrestricted move of up to twice his relevant move meters. In a sprint action, a character discards a token to perform a restricted move of up to 3 times his relevant move meters. But upon completing the sprint, the character must immediately make a willpower attempt at difficulty factor 10 or gain the winded condition. In a leap action, a character discards a token to move in a straight line after any facing changes equal to the character's leap meters. Since the move is a leap, it may allow the character to avoid any surface hazards between the start and end points of the leap. Similarly, in a running leap action, a character discards a token to perform a restricted move of up to the character's run meters, and then an additional straight move of up to twice the character's leap meters. As with a sprint, however, after performing a running leap, a character must immediately attempt to resist the winded condition. In a ram action, a character discards a token to perform a restricted move of up to 3 times the character's relevant move meters, causing impact damage to anything into which its path carries it, which may also injure the character. After ramming his final target, the character must complete a minimum move. And, as with the sprint, after performing a ram, a character must immediately attempt to resist gaining the winded condition. For details on executing rams, see the Savage Soul rules. In a forfeit action, a character discards a token, but does nothing else. In other words, the character simply forfeits his opportunity to act. In an aim action, a character discards a token to move up to half his relevant move meters, and then gain the defenseless condition. At the same time, the character marks a target with an aim counter, which, on subsequent attacks, will grant the character a +2 attack bonus against the marked target, and may improve the range score of certain ranged weapons used against the marked target. The aim counter must immediately be removed if the character loses the defenseless condition or loses line of sight to the marked target. Similarly, with a concentrate action, the character discards a token to gain the concentrate condition, which has the effect of rendering him defenseless, but improves his chances of performing subsequent task attempts, including spell casting. This is explained in detail in the spell casting tutorial. If a designated character does not wish to act immediately, but wishes to preserve his opportunity to perform subsequent reactions, such as attack a moving character or preemptive attack, the character may discard a token to perform the guard action. The character may then move up to his relevant move meters and gain the guard condition. Until the end of the combat round, the character may then discard the guard condition to perform a subsequent reaction, as if the guard condition was an unused ready token. Additionally, the guard condition may allow the character to serve as a human shield against certain ranged attacks that pass within 2 meters. See the Savage Soul rules for more details regarding the guard condition. In a lockstep action, the character discards a token to gain the lockstep condition, which essentially delays the character's move until later in the combat round when another friendly character performs a move. The character then discards the lockstep condition and performs a free double time, sprint, leap, running leap, or ram action at the same time as the friendly character's move. Thus, instead of friendly characters advancing upon an enemy one at a time, it's possible for them to all advance together. In a recover from stun action, a character discards a token to remove the stun condition. When a character subject to the stun condition is designated to activate, he must perform a recover from stun action. While ongoing dialogue in combat is highly encouraged and is generally free, certain verbal actions have defined combat effects and thus require a character to perform the command action. Examples include issuing specific instructions to an NPC, relaying a specific piece of important information, or attempting intimidation or taunt. Command action also allows for a move of up to the character's relevant move meters. In a trick action, a character discards a token and attempts to use his performance attribute against an opponent's intelligence attribute to achieve certain effects. See the Savage Soul rules for more details regarding the trick action. In a coordinate action, the designated leader of a force may direct any number of members of his force to immediately discard tokens to perform a coordinated fire or mob attack against a single target. In order to perform a coordinate action, the leader must have a token remaining, but he need not discard it. Thus, the leader of a force could conceivably perform multiple coordinate actions in a single combat round, even if he has only a single ready or motivation token. In a rally action, the designated leader of a force discards a token, moves up to his relevant move meters, and then makes a leadership attempt at difficulty factor 12 to eliminate fear and panic conditions from all members of his force that are within line of sight. Finally, if a character wishes to do anything not specifically covered by one of the previously described actions, he must perform either an instant action or a task attempt action, depending upon what he is trying to accomplish. In an instant action, the character discards a token to perform an unrestricted move of up to his relevant move meters or a restricted move of up to twice his relevant move meters, and then performs a simple task that usually does not require a task attempt. Common examples of instant actions include picking up objects, opening doors, drawing weapons, consuming potions, etc. A task attempt action is similar, except that the character cannot move and may attempt an action that is somewhat more complex than would be possible with an instant action. A common example of a task attempt action is spell casting. If a task could arguably be performed either as an instant action or a task attempt action, the GM may allow a character to choose which action he wishes to perform, but apply an attempt penalty, usually -2, if the character attempts the task as an instant action. And now on to reactions. Unlike an action, a character cannot perform a reaction when he is designated to activate. Rather, he may only perform a reaction when the required conditions for that reaction are satisfied. For example, a character may only choose to perform an active defense reaction after an attacker's attack total equals or exceeds the character's passive defense. Or, in other words, only when the character is actually hit by an attack. Performing the active defense reaction will then grant the character a chance to block or dodge in an attempt to negate the attack or reduce its effectiveness. Attacks, blocks, and dodges will be explained in the tutorial on resolving attacks. The abort reaction allows a character to eliminate the defenseless or concentration condition at the time an enemy declares an attack against the character, but before the enemy makes his attack roll. Once an enemy makes his attack roll, it is too late to declare an abort reaction. As a result, an attacker should always give his target a chance to decide whether to abort before making an attack roll. As will be explained in the next tutorial, a character's facing in the Savage Soul can be critical. The Watch Your Back reaction allows a character to change facing whenever any opponent moves from within the character's front 180-degree arc to outside the character's front 180-degree arc. Similarly, a Face the Foe reaction allows a character to change facing when he is the target of a charge and strike or move and shoot action. So, if this thugger were standing behind Stephanie and performed a shoot action against her, the thugger would be shooting Stephanie in the back. But if the thugger performed a move and shoot action instead, Stephanie could discard a token to perform a face the foe reaction and have a better chance of surviving the attack. In an attack a moving character reaction, a character may discard his token to perform an out-of-sequence attack against a moving opponent. This attack can either be a shoot attack at a -2 attack penalty or a strike attack with no attack penalty. This can, for example, allow a character to shoot an opponent that is running from one concealed position to another concealed position, or shoot a charging attacker before that attacker comes within melee range. A preemptive attack reaction is similar to an attack a moving character reaction, except that it can be performed when an opponent declares any action. In this case, however, the designated character and the preempting character must engage in a competing quickness task. If the preempting character wins the quickness challenge, he may attack the designated character before the designated character performs his declared action, but will suffer a -2 attack penalty. If the preempting character loses the quickness challenge, his discarded token is forfeited and he cannot perform any attack against the designated character. Additionally, if a character attempted preemptive attack instead of active defense, he may be unable to attempt a block or dodge against the designated character's attack. In a sidestep reaction, a character discards his token to move 2 meters in any direction without changing facing whenever another character is moving or when subject to an explosive or area effect attack. A dive reaction is similar to a sidestep reaction, except that the character changes facing to the direction he wishes to move and may move up to 2 meters or the character's leap meters, whichever is greater. At the end of the leap, the character may make an athletics attempt at difficulty factor 10 to remain standing. Otherwise, the character will be prone at the end of his leap. A desperation dive is also similar, except that it can only be performed if the character is subject to a ram, trample, explosive, or area effect attack. Additionally, the token cost of a desperation dive is discard or free, so it can be attempted even if a character has no token remaining. When attempting a desperation dive, a character must make a successful perception attempt at difficulty factor 10. If the attempt is successful, the character may perform a free sidestep or dive. But if the character chooses to dive, he will automatically become prone. If the character's perception attempt is unsuccessful, the character cannot sidestep or dive and will suffer the effects of the ram, trample, explosion, or area effect. Special reactions relate to certain special reaction spells that have their own specified conditions, such as counterspell or combat blink. Special reaction spells are explained in the spell casting tutorial. When a member of a designated leader's force is required to resist intimidation, taunt, fear, or panic, the designated leader may discard a token to perform a maintain order reaction. This will allow any member of the leader's force to use the leader's leadership score when making the resistance attempt, and this effect will last until the end of the combat round. A character's final combat option is rest. This is neither an action nor a reaction, and must be declared before the designated leader's assigned motivation and ready tokens. A character declaring a rest is not assigned a motivation or ready token, and is, instead, assigned the defenseless condition. If the character remains defenseless until the end of the combat round, he may make a willpower attempt at difficulty factor 10 to remove the winded condition. Additionally, for every 2 full rounds that a character rests during any 12 combat round interval, the character will gain a +1 bonus toward his willpower attempt to resist gaining the winded condition. And those are all the possible actions and reactions a character may perform during a combat round in the Savage Soul. The next tutorial will take a closer look at movement and facing. If you're enjoying these videos or finding them helpful, please leave a like below. Also, consider subscribing so you'll receive a notification whenever new tutorials are posted. Thank you.